Steve Dahl Show is brought to you by Budweiser. For all you do, this Bud's for you. I'm Gary Meier.
Ladies and gentlemen, oh! I don't need to do that. Hello? You know, I was hoping that we could start off the show. I said to myself, Steve, you want to take this one? Dan?
I want you to put your hand up my shirt to take it out from underneath.
I sabotaged this microphone. No, put your hand up under my shirt. You got to put it up under to pull it out.
Ooh.
I sabotaged this just so I could get him to do it. Oh, damn. It's in my back pocket. Go ahead. Ooh. Go ahead. Take it out. Not my wallet, just the transmitter. I was hoping we could start the show off with a technical difficulty. We rent the wireless microphones for $150 a week, and they don't work. And that's what I love about show business. I'm not even drinking beer tonight. I'll admit it, the last couple of shows I drank beer because I figured, what the hell? Everything's going wrong around me. I might as well enjoy myself. But tonight, coffee. Can you get a shot at that? That's coffee. Where do you want me to point? Is that, am I pointing at the right place? There. Can you see? It's coffee, I swear to God, look. There it is, coffee. Or dark beer. Could be either, really. But I'm really trying. So, we had a technical difficulty, but... And do I have a partner? Am I doing like a solo show tonight, or what?
No, I'm here.
Where are you?
I'm behind the curtain. I want to pretend like I'm Johnny Carson. Introduce me.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, without further ado, a man who, up until about 5 minutes ago, didn't know that there were two makeup kits, one with Steve on it, one with Gary. Could you go get our makeup kit, somebody? Lenny or somebody?
Yeah.
A man who's standing behind the curtain because he wants to come out like Johnny Carson. A man... I say we just leave him back there. We never introduce him. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome a man whose nose is obviously out of joint because this is the Steve Dahl Show with Gary Meier, and that's why he wants the big introduction. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Mr. Gary Myers!
Today.
How warm is it?
It is so warm that all the bums are stripped down to their first layer of dirt. I want to tell you. Super.
Hey, I don't like being the sidekick, okay? So,
Hey, two wireless mics not working.
Yeah, so we're doing the handheld thing tonight. Makes it a little tough to do the show the way I had it planned.
I don't think so. I can walk around like this all day.
Yeah, but it's hard for me to do little things that, you know, that I want to do. Like... put these on the band. Their little Happy New Year. Tiaras. Got enough hairspray in there? Oh, no, this is getting sick. This is a cable show, Roman. These guys spend like a half hour in the bathroom. More time than Gary does. Got to talk into a microphone. It's one of the concepts we're trying to work on here. No, I don't think you can. Maybe you can. I wouldn't take... for granted the fact that anybody can hear you on this show.
It's not hairspray. I haven't taken a shower for 2 weeks.
Okay,
what do you
fine.
Got? You got a plastic heart or something?
You got to listen to their hair. Listen to it.
Listen to their hair.
All right, this is just some sort of paper or something. Listen. Listen to this. Got enough hairspray in there, John?
I don't know. I don't know.
Greggy Wegg, how about you?
Why don't you go to Greg? Wait, go to Greg last, because I'd like to chat with him for a second.
Okay. Hi, Ed.
I got hairspray on today, too.
Yeah. At least they use hairspray to affect a now happening look, Ed. You're stuck somewhere in the 70s. I'm going to part it in the middle. You think that's happening? Yeah, no, I do. I think it is. Oh, yours is soft and fluffy. Don't give me that. You're the dry look. Okay.
And now Greg Potter.
Styling gel.
Oh, it's
like somebody spat in your hair or something. Oh, and it smells terrible. It smells like a bad sexual thing. Okay. Oh.
Okay. I wanted to go to Greg last because we were in makeup about an hour ago, and we were talking about Christmas and what we all got for Christmas, and this guy got some interesting things, and he didn't bring them in today, but he's going to bring them in next Friday.
Well, okay. Greg, how old are you now? 24?
23.
23.
Yeah.
But, well, stand up. Oh, you are standing.
Yeah.
Go ahead, stand up. He's pretty little, because Gary's only 5 feet.
Is that pretty come a little?
That too. How tall are you, Gary?
6'7". In my stocking feet. About 5'13".
No, really?
5'10", 11". Something.
All right, so Greg's short. And now the hair, Greg's hair adds about 4 inches. And his parents still like to treat him like a little kid.
Like he's 7.
Yeah, like you're 7.
Yeah.
And what did you get for Christmas?
He doesn't mind that. No, he got some fun things. Like?
Well, toy-wise in the toy department.
See, he gets toys. And then he gets, like, clothes.
You know, serious gifts.
Yeah. Grown-up things.
And does Santa still come?
Quite.
I think he might have in your hair. You might want to check on that.
Yeah. There's a Santa Claus type thing.
Yeah.
I do remember it being the same since I was...
You still leave the cookies, and they're half-eaten, and the milk is half-gone.
Well,
a little note. Thanks, Greg. Love your hair, Santa. Something like that.
Tell us about the clothing first.
Okay. Clothing-wise, this is from Freddie now. That's my dad. He got me some boa constrictor boots.
Made out of boa constrictor?
Yeah, like snakeskin boots. These aren't them, but next week.
Bring
we'll
those
see
in next week.
We'll
yeah.
see them next
yeah.
week. And then Betty, she's more of a.
That's your mom.
Mother. She's more fashion minded. Fred's kind of wild.
Now you call your parents Fred and Betty, right?
Yeah.
Who doesn't?
Yeah, everyone does. Everyone. Then she's more fashion minded, so I just got some regular leather clothing, some new leather, real things.
I got this for you, Gary.
In the toy department,
we get the feathers because it's our show.
I got an Elvis Presley tour van.
Yeah.
And an Elvis Presley doll that goes.
Really? And a Dr. Nick doll that fills the tour van up with drugs?
No, a Michael Jackson doll who keeps. I got a Michael Jackson too.
Really?
And then the Wayne Gretzky doll from last year rides along with them too for security.
Describe the van.
Well, it's, what's wild is it is new. It's a 1984 toy. So they're still digging Elvis. And it's purple, and it's about this big.
That's, next year it's going to be the Prince van.
Yeah,
the Prince tour van.
Yeah, so...
Purple van! Purple van!
So it's about a foot and a half or maybe 2 feet long.
A monster.
Yeah. And Elvis, little Elvis.
We mean the van.
Yeah, little Elvis. Little Elvis is that.
Happy New Year, man.
That's great. He's about 10 inches. He's about 10 inches.
Who, Little Elvis?
Little Elvis.
Oh, yours Little Elvis, too?
Yeah.
Hey, that's what I call mine, Little Elvis.
Yeah, and it's, well, the van's got little sliding doors, and you put Elvis in, and he just tours.
It's good. And you're how old?
Yeah. Oh, I didn't say I pushed it around the basement. But
yeah.
Skender came over, he played with it like he pushed it around. And that, too, it makes a motor sound.
Oh, you don't have to make your own?
No, it really happened. And
no, that's the sound of Elvis gurgling in the back.
Well, that's why Gretzky drives. And then Michael Jackson just sits and talks, and Elvis lays in the back with his guitar.
There's a little
IV.
Yeah, there's a little racquetball court in the van. It's great. You got to bring that in next week.
And 2 years ago, I got the Kiss doll, so they go on tour too. but I can't get their makeup off. So they have to go on as the old tour, the 75 tour. So next year I'll bring it, I mean next week I'll bring in all my
toys.
Well,
that's okay because Elvis is dead, so it's better to keep, you know, keep
okay,
the 75
so Kiss
happening.
Yeah.
Your jealousy, Roman, is so unbecoming. All right, you're not happening, but don't take it away from those dudes who are still on the cutting edge, those Kiss dudes. All right? All right, your jealousy is not becoming.
I'm just
the
disappointed.
Tiara, however, is. You
I'm
look
disappointed
incredible.
That they had to cancel New Year's.
Yeah, they had a scheduling problem. They scheduled a concert.
What, New Year's is off?
No
well,
one,
take this stuff down.
That no one
that.
Wanted to go to, so they had
what,
a scheduling
what,
problem.
What? You mean
Happy
Kiss.
New Year.
You mean Kiss.
Yeah, that's what he said.
There's a headset back here. Is anybody, are we missing someone? are we missing a staff member? I can't keep my tiara on. I'm going to need some bobby pins, John.
Yeah, really?
Do you have any?
I'm sure he, oh, yeah, no, I don't, I'm a real man.
Yeah, right. You wear more hairspray than my mother.
All right.
Are we missing a staff member?
We're going to check on that, but we have to
we
break
have a
here.
Set of headphones here.
It's our special New Year's show.
Continues.
After these messages. We're going to be doing some poppers later?
Yeah.
All right.
Number one.
Is the loneliest number that...
I'll look wherever you want. Number one, I want to... Let's not start this again. Okay. Number one. You can't hear you. Oh, yeah.
You might want to use the microphone.
I forgot about the technical difficulty we're having.
We're more like Sadler and Young now. you remember those guys, don't you? They're wild.
Yes, I do. I do. Name a song they used to do.
They did everything in French or something, didn't they? Or one guy was singing in French while the other guy did it in English.
I want to make it with you.
Je pourvous.
I'll
bet they worked on their own cars, too. Hey, let's change the oil in our car. Yeah, right.
We must change the oil in our car.
The shiniest fingernails I've ever seen.
What are you saying?
I'm saying they don't work on their own cars, that's all. They go to those 10-minute
like
oil changes. Yeah, that's right.
Gary, put that up on the hoist for me, would you? I want you to check my differential. I just don't like the way it feels when I downshift into third. Okay.
Here we go.
Put it up on the rack. There are some... Christmas commercials on the show tonight. Don't ask me why.
Like
for the
what?
The Waterbed store, right? For Peppers, they didn't have any new ones, so...
It's still the season. I mean,
money's money, you know. They said, we'll just run the Christmas ones. We said, well, will you still pay us? And they said, sure. I said, sounds super. Now, I don't want to appear to be trivial.
But you will be.
Well... I don't know. Correct me if I'm wrong. No, see, we have these makeup kits. Okay. See that? And we get these pads to put the makeup on your face. And I don't really use mine very much. I don't use mine as much as Gary does because I figure when you look like me, you know, what's makeup going to do? No, let's be serious. So I just maybe put a little on, hide the bags under my eyes and stuff. But Gary comes in and uses more than I do because he likes the tan stuff. You know, the beachy guy. Gary, the beachy guy. And it's upside down here, but each one of these boxes has our, you know, this is Gary's box, this is Steve's box. And he continually uses my pad.
Just to sleep at once in a while, man.
As well as his, can you hear me when I have it down like that? I mean, is that okay? As well as his own. And I don't know. It's just, it's like used toilet paper or something. I wish you would use your own pad. Every week I get a new pad. I come in and he's using my new pad. And I really, I just really think that you ought to get it together, man, and be more professional.
Okay.
And I also think you should use this more of this pink lip gloss, because your lips look pale to me.
I want to just kind of gradually break all that.
But Gary, I come in, he's putting it all over his entire body in case he has to do a nude scene or something. I come in, he's naked, he's rubbing it on his thighs. Oh, yeah, all over tan.
You never know when your pants are going to ride up. And, you know, like you see on the Carson show, they have their pants way up here. You know, that white leg, you know? I don't like that.
Oh.
These are white stockings, that's not my leg.
I'm very hot, but I'm wearing a Christmas gift. I thought, you know, it's the first show after Christmas. You know how people always show up at work the day after Christmas? Yeah. People always show up the day after Christmas at work with new stuff on. Is that a new thing? That's a new
negative
thing. No?
No. I bought this myself about a year ago.
Really?
Yeah.
How do you keep your clothing looking so new? Woolite?
Yes. And cling free.
So I might take this off. This was a gift from Janet. It's nice, isn't it?
Has she checked in? Can she see the show?
She hasn't called, so I would think that she can. Has she checked in? I guess it's working. I don't know. I'll find out when I get home, I guess. Now, I'm going to take this off because I'm really hot.
Hey, a little music for this, huh?
Oh, hey, speaking of that, can we see the stripping Santa? Who wants to see the stripping Santa? Band members? Band members? All of them. I paid, it cost me $100 to have that guy come down here last week, and he told me it was going to be 10 minutes. It was only 3 minutes. Right? Three what? $3.35. I paid for 10 minutes. 10 seconds of it is a joke of mine, so it's only $3.25. So, not only because I paid $100 for the stripper, but because this can be sort of our year in review show, the best of, you know, our cable show. This could be that, you know, the best of our cable show. Really, that's the only thing we have worth showing. So now we present, is that ready to go? We present, as I take off my coat, the best of our cable show so far, The Stripping Santa.
Okay.
Stuffer.
If you think
happened? Hey, hey, hey.
Thank God that wasn't on camera, Gary.
Roman's clutching the microphone over there.
Like a Louisville slugger. Club, yeah, right here. Santa likes to keep the North Pole at his pad when he travels.
We're gonna break here.
Merry Christmas.
You gotta talk into the microphone. It works much better. This is a man who yells at his family for not talking into the microphone.
Well, I'm used to having the little lavalier thing, but those have broken down on us. Hey, we're only spending $150 a week on them. What do you expect? Actually, yours didn't work last week, so they gave us this week for free. Oh, whoopee. Neither of them worked. All right, we're going to come back. Merry Christmas is what I was saying. From our house to yours via the stripping Santa. Now, I gave him a tip.
Get out of this business.
No, please, gentlemen. After the show, I said, you know, you should leave the hat on, don't you think? He should leave some Santa stuff on. Because all of a sudden he goes from Santa to new wave guy in leather, and then that's it. You know, there's no more Santa. I say the beard and the hat.
Yeah. Did he take your advice? Or?
Yeah, he gave me a kiss full on the mouth and said, "You're incredible." I said, "Merry Xmas." Putting the X back in Xmas. Okay, we're going to take another break here, and we'll be back in just 1 second. Don't go away.
Yes.
We're making a rare personal appearance.
That's Monday night, New Year's Eve, as you can see on your screen, at the stadium after the Sting game. The Sting won tonight 5-4. That's 9 in a row, right?
They're so hot.
They're in first place.
For foreigners.
First place.
And that's without who?
Pato and Rudy Glenn. Two very important starters.
So that's Monday. The Sting game starts at what time?
6 o'clock. 6 o'clock game time. Should be over by 8.
We'll be on about 8:30, between 8:30 and 9. And then everything's done at 10:30, so you can still head over to the State Street Mall, like we're going to do, and shop.
Yeah. Tickets reasonably priced at between $5 and $11, and that is reasonable because I charge my family $15 just to see me in the morning. I won't come downstairs until I get $45 from the wife and the two kids. So that's reasonable.
The band pays more than they have to get in usually.
Yeah. So that's a damn good price.
Tickets at Ticketron or go to the stadium Monday and get them there when you show up.
Yeah, I'm sure. They seat 17,000. I would think there might be some room for you Monday night.
I don't know.
I don't want you to be doing a Jesus Christ thing. No room at the stadium. So you might want to just make sure you get those tickets.
I see you're over at our party table.
Yeah. Yeah. Are we going to do the WLS thing here now?
Oh, we have a script.
Okay, I'll hold up the pictures, you read the script.
All right, it's two parts. It's two parts, Steve. You want me to read your part, too?
Yes, please.
Steve
says, read it in my voice.
Steve says, "Hey, Gary, did you know that our radio show is ending early on Monday?" I say, "Yes, Steve." And Steve says, "But do you know why our show is ending early on Monday, you scumbag?" And I say, "I thought that John Guerin wanted to give us time to get ready for New Year's Eve." And you say,
"This is John Guerin."
This is like Mission Impossible. Then you say,
This is scum, ladies and gentlemen. Or as we call him out, the Big Belt Bucko.
You'll hear that song Monday night. Steve says, "No, that's not quite it. We're making room for Jeff Davis."
There's me talking. I'll get Jeff.
"Hey, ain't Jeff wonderful to come in and count down the top 89 songs?"
Here's you in your GQ thing. I loved it when you went through this phase.
And guess what happens at
midnight? Wait, I got to get Jeff Davis. Hold on. Here's you humping me.
All right, where's
this
Jeff?
This is our press photo. This has to be bad for our image, right?
What image?
Well, you're like mounting me from behind in a pair of leather pants.
You insisted.
Okay, but I didn't know he was going to take a picture of it.
Jeff Davis.
Tommy Edwards.
All right. Les Grabstein. He'll be on stage with us Monday night. Okay, that's another Les. I mean, people, come on. No, can only take
and
some.
This, if you're wondering, this is a good picture. Okay. It was a flattering picture.
That's Tim Kelly.
Tim Kelly.
Jeff.
There he is, the Jeffer. And this is an actual size photograph. Let me hold my hand up in front of you. Actual size. No bigger than my hand, this man's head.
And guess what happens at midnight? When I say horns, blowers, millions of people.
Oh, super.
Millions of people at the State Street Mall throwing confetti and drinking champagne. Hey, that's not too much of a volatile combination.
That's it is. The ever sexy Mr. Mike Wolf.
And Steve says,
look at that. Look at Mike Wolf.
Don't make me. Don't be silly, Gary. Jeff will be playing the number one song of 1984. I've been waiting all year for this. I can't believe you didn't know about this. Are you out of it or what? Then I say, heck no. I voted for my favorite artist on the back of the music radio survey, and I'm going to be listening for the results Monday night starting at 5 p.m. on 89 WLS and the new 94.7 WLS FM.
We don't promote the FM, though, because we're on the AM.
Right, so check out the AM.
Yeah, if you just happen to be wandering across your cable box, maybe you tripped and fell and maybe you tripped and fell and this show accidentally came on. We are on the radio every day, Monday through Friday. We haven't been promoting ourselves properly on this show. But we can use this show to show ourselves as much as we want. We're on every day, Monday through Friday, on WLS AM 89 from 2:30 in the afternoon till 7. Listen, won't you?
And if you need more information about us, we have a hotline that's updated daily.
Yeah. You are right on with
you
this.
You want me to
dude.
Go? I'll go on it. 976-4242. We also operate an elderly care service. We take people in a van to shopping malls.
And they never come back.
Let's do some poppers.
We take care of your problem with the elderly.
Do
they
some poppers, dude.
I got a brick for tonight.
Brick of poppers. Boy, these have been around a long time. When I was a kid, I used to, like, these were a quarter.
These aren't the ones you put up to your nose.
No.
You'll burn yourself. You'll do, like, a John Eric Hexum on yourself, so don't do that. We better get cracking here if we're going to do your song.
Okay, it says right way, wrong way. Okay, I think I've got the hang of this.
Ah!
Happy New Year! Poppy.
There's no string on this one.
You just stomp on that with your foot. Do poppers. You guys want to do poppers?
There you go.
All right. Are we ready for the song?
Yeah, we're going to do, Gary has written a year in review song for us.
Mike Spence.
Ah! Hey, watch it. Hope this one gets a little bit further than the 12 days of Christmas we tried a couple of weeks ago. We still have the, for next year, we've got to start on it. Remember when I was taking nouns from the audience?
Yeah.
On the first day of Christmas, my true love gave to me a breast full of baby's milk. On the second day of Christmas, my true love gave to me two breast pumps and a breast full of baby's milk. On the third day of Christmas, my true love gave to me three holsters with guns, two breast pumps and a breast full of baby's milk, et cetera, et cetera. For next year. Now, I'm just going to do this myself on the Casio. I like to do this every once in a while to put the band in their place.
And it does every time.
Well, tonight, great. For example, Greg, the drummer, Johnny, the bass player, and Eddie were 45 minutes late. They walk in. I always tell them I'm going to dock them $1 a minute for every minute they're late. But they know I never do, so I go, hey, you guys are late. Cut it out. Okay, we're sorry. Then they always have some cockamamie story. Well, there was this busload of nuns. And you know that gas they had in India to kill all those people? It hit a truck with that gas in it, and we had to neutralize the gas and give CPR to the nuns. So every once in a while, I like to remind the band that they can be replaced by this one.
And while you're playing that, we're going to go into a commercial break. and then we'll come back and do the song.
You getting this up in the control room?
Good job.
But this doesn't dress as well as the band does. And it doesn't shake its ass like Skender does when he's rocking.
Hockey jersey kind of hiding over there.
It always does it for Greg. Like Skender will be going, check me out, dude. I'm rocking. Check out my ass. It's always very hot when you two do that. I love that. We have fun on the road, don't we? Yeah. Okay, so here we go. The series Year in Review.
Take another look at this year, 1984. Just
too fast for me.
Sounds good.
Hey, dude.
Good job. It had the usual sprinkling of nonsense from John Hinckley. Steve and I got a big thrill when we met Christy Brinkley. The first 3 months of the year, we spent making an extremely low-budget TV show.
We were really together. We'd have, like, pictures to go with them.
Come on.
But we're not together.
It'd take hours. We don't have that much time.
It's a cable show. All right, here we go. Want to start over? Let's start over for the feeling.
Let's go.
Okay,
let's take another look at this year, 1984. It had the usual sprinkling of nonsense from John Hinckley. And Steve and I got a big thrill when we met Christy Brinkley. The first 3 months of the year we spent making an extremely low-budget TV show.
Ooh.
We ate sushi, went to a toy store, and she was dressed up as Michael Jackson and acted like a real bro. And speaking of the Jacksons, this is the year they went on their victory tour. Because Michael is such a nice guy, he kept his brothers out of his tour. This is the year of the Olympics. The Russians pulled out, and as Petroni would say, those guys are a bunch of bogus dudes. People in Ethiopia are really starving. And it was easier to be gay this year than last, except if your name was Marvin. And I know some of you are anxious to call someone on the top of Twitter. Hey, how about those socks? They really went down the crapper. And sorry, Charlie, we almost had a new chicken of the sea. When a kid went sledding with his father and fell through the ice, yes, you know him as the ice boy, Jimmy T. Hey, how about that guy who won the $40 million lotto? That should have been won by you or me or even Dan Pilato. Paul McCartney put out a movie. It was quite a stiff. And for $1.9 million, you two could own a guy named Sutcliffe. Shake it out. Shake it out.
Hey, I can do this by myself.
Battle of the band.
and India certainly wasn't too keen. And neither was getting kicked out of the front row by Bruce Springsteen. Steve made his movie debut in Grandview, USA. The movie did about as well as Babyface. Movie debut in Grandview, USA. The movie did about as well as Babyface. Yes, she was the owner of a baboon heart. Then there's a guy with a plastic wand who will be able to buy bodily parts at Kmart. One thing I know for certain, people who will not be 85 include Andy Kaufman, Stephen Capote, David Kennedy, Peter Lawford, and Richard Burton. That movie Ghostbusters made millions. But I had more fun looking at pictures of Vanessa Williams. How about those Chicago Bears? They win their division and no one cares. Little did we know this year we would move from FM to AM. We went to court and lost. That didn't even happen to DeLorean. Supposedly 11% of the American public is using cocaine. Prince made his money legally through Purple Rain. Did anything this year turn out like George Orwell predicted? Such as Indira Gandhi dying from gunshot wounds inflicted. Then there was the re-election of Ronald Reagan. At that moment, I wanted to be a billion miles away in a place only known by Carl Sagan. There were some sad notes this year with the acting of Rain in the Jar. And who will forget Skip getting an accident with Steve's car? Steve certainly won't. On the happier side, Steve and Janet are expecting child number three. Steve says, I'm in serious trouble if it looks anything like me. Time doesn't permit me to make this list complete.
I'm getting tired.
People not mentioned extensively were Clara Peller, Boy George, Walter Payton, Jerry Ferraro, and Mike Ditka, whose command of the English language will never be beat. Now we're into the last year of our contract. Next time we're going to get exactly what we want, and that's a fact, Jack. Oh yeah, the cable show is new. Anything else you need to know, you can call 976-4242.